You're insecure, don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up. Being the way that you are is enough. Everyone else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you.
Today, we have something exciting planned. So, Jillian and I used to be pretty cringy, well, me especially, used to be pretty cringy in the past, specifically me.
I was cringy too.
I don't think so, but
I definitely think so.
So today, Jillian and I are becoming our past cringy selves. We kinda got this idea from the Dolan twins. They became their past cringy selves too. So we're gonna put on our old, like, clothes similar to the clothes we used to wear when we were younger. And then we're gonna go do some activities that we would love to do when we were younger. So, let's go! I'm sitting in my beanbag because Jelaine says it makes me look cooler. Oh, by the way, this video is, like, not from one specific time period. So, I'm mainly making my look around the cringiest look ever, which was me in middle school. So, and then the activities are like elementary school. Anyway, so my outfit from middle school, I always wore really colorful leggings and then like a skirt on top of that. And then knee-high socks that were two different colors or patterns. And then like some random shirt. And then I wore a bunch of like rubber bracelets. And then sometimes I wear moon rings on my hands. And I also wore headbands. And I'd clip a bunch of bows in my headbands. And I had rainbow suspenders that I wore sometimes, but I got rid of them, so. Anyway, I'm gonna go scrounge up a look that is similar to my middle school look, which was very cool, as you may tell from the description.
Okay, so this look is probably mainly middle school, probably, but probably early high school too. So what I used to wear a lot, I would always wear pink every single day, which I still do a lot, but it's not overly pink, you know what I mean? It's just like happens to be pink, but I used to be overly pink. I would wear a lot of cat shirts because I love cats. And these things that we call tube shorts. Tube shorts go down to about your knees. I'll insert a picture because we don't have any tube shorts anymore because we got rid of them all. So I'm just gonna wear some pink shorts. I also had these really tiny, thick glasses. They're terrible. I hate them. And then I used to always wear my hair in a low ponytail. And now, my hair probably looks messy, but I straighten my hair nowadays, but back then it was like super frizzy, which is why I wore it in a ponytail and I never wore it down. I'm gonna go get dressed now.
So here's what I look like nowadays, and then here's what I look like in the past. Let me try that again because I feel like it didn't work. Oh! this is kind of awkward, like me in middle school.
Okay, so this is the before, and now this is the after. Oh no! Ew!
As you can see, I have these buttons. One says Hufflepuff, because I'm a major Harry Potter stan. And then the other one is homemade and says happy, because I'm happy, look. And then, okay, these aren't really true to my style back then. I'd be wearing a skater skirt, kind of like, you know, but at least these are kind of long. My dad's calling me, just a second.
So these are my actual glasses that I used to wear. Except, they're broken somehow. I have no idea how they got like that. And then here's, you know, the cat shirt that I would wear, probably. And then these shorts, they're not the best because they don't even go to my fingertips. And I know I always had shorts past my fingertips. But I still can't believe how long they are. I never wear shorts this long. My hair is in a low ponytail. I haven't worn it like this in years. I'm gonna put my normal glasses on because, first of all, I hate these and they feel really heavy and they're broken. And second of all, I can't see.
Hey guys, I'm joined with a friend. Anyway, so we actually planned out this video a lot. And so now we're gonna do some of the activities that we used to do when we were in elementary and middle school, such as going to the park, swinging on the swings, and throwing markers off the swings. So I guess we should go do that first. Flilbert. You guys are probably wondering, guys, why on earth would you throw markers off the swings? Believe us, we're wondering that too.
I have no idea why we did this, but I know for like a good summer, we did it every day in the evening. We just went to the park and threw markers off the swing. I'm scared.
Me too.
Yeah, man. So we back in the club with the bodies rocking from side to side, side, side to side. Thank God the week is done. I feel like a zombie gone back to life, back, back to life. Dance up, yeah, suddenly we all got our hands up. No control of my body, ain't I seen you before? I think I remember those eyes, eyes.
So we just finished throwing markers off the swings, and to be honest, it was kind of more fun than we thought it would be.
You should try it at home.
Yeah, we thought it would be like ridiculous, but it was like kind of satisfying. We see our parents. oh no! Oh! There they are.
Back in 8th grade.
Don't look down.
Okay, so the next activity we're doing is pretending to be grandmas. For some reason, we made our mouths like do it that, and we pretended to be like really old, and we used to have these canes that we walked around the house with.
They were like candy canes.
Why did we do these
things?
I think she was like the really old grandma, and yeah. I was just like a normal grandma.
She was like the young grandma or something.
I don't even know what we did.
We just talked in weird voices.
I don't know how to do it, so I don't know if I want to take part in the scene.
By the way, this happened when we were in elementary school.
I'm gearing up to become a grandma.
When I was in elementary school, the main thing that I liked to do in my free time was play with American Girl dolls. And I had about 4 of them. I got one for Christmas like every year. So let's go find them because I still have them. I'm not gonna get them down because
Tian.
They're like so perfect up there, but I'll get a flashlight.
This right here.
That's so creepy.
I got this one when I was 8, I think. Her name is Mia. this one I got the next year for Christmas. It's Krissa. And then I got Julie the next year when I was 10. And then finally I got Kanani. I used to play school with them a lot. And that's all I did, I think.
So it's childhood trauma. Now we enter my mess of a room. Oh, hey, look who's back there. I think someone's back there. What is this doing? Let's get her down. This is my American Girl doll, Ruthie. I got her when I was 6, and you should probably not get an American Girl doll when you're 6, because her hair once was curly. Now look at it. It looks like mine. And she used to wear these really disgusting outfit things, but I put her in some cool outfits because, look, she listens to music and everything. She's relatable.
So usually I didn't do this. Usually I did art. If you do a little pan around my room, you can see many arts. And you may think, wow, this girl must love art. Actually, that is not the case. You see, from like early elementary school to 8th grade, I was in this art program thing. And I just did art like all day. Well, not all day, but you know. And I don't know, I got really tired of art, but I used to love it. I used to hate math and science. But then in 8th grade, I hated art and I became obsessed with math. It was crazy, it was really weird. Like geometry, I took geometry in 8th grade. But the summer before 8th grade, I like learned all of geometry on Khan Academy. Shout out to Sal. Because I was just so obsessed with math. I hated art. Anyway, let's go listen to some music.
I'm sweltering. Now let's listen to some throwbacks. I have some requests, and Jillian has a playlist of classics.
I listen to music on YouTube, by the way.
I still remember all the words.
Me too. Okay, while we listen to music, we're going to tell some childhood stories. Or, like, not specific stories, but some things that happened.
Habits. Let's change the song now, because, you know, we can't have too much of one song.
Alright.
James, where else are we in?
Okay, I don't remember this song. I can't wait to listen to this.
I'm so excited. I've listened to this, like, 2 years, because...
I remember that. It's from 2011.
I love All Star Weekend so much. You guys don't understand. Okay, time for a story time. Okay, so when we were in like elementary school, after dinner we used to roughhouse with our dad. So like we'd roll around on the floor and then he'd roll around and he'd pretend he was gonna crush us and we'd call that game Steamroller. And then he'd like pick us up and put us on the couch and we'd call that game Forklift. Just get in your song.
Guys, sometimes I listen to the song just so you know.
It's by Justin Bieber. Please don't click off.
It's from 2009. Okay, it's
if you pretend it's a girl, it's good.
Do you remember this?
No.
What?
Except from like 2 weeks ago when you showed me it. Why are you thrashing your phone?
Okay.
Okay, so then another roughhouse game we used to play with our dad was called Run to Daddy. Our dad likes baseball, so we'd run to him, and he'd pretend that he was gonna, like, hit us with a bat. Because, like, we were the ball, and then he had, like, the bat. But he didn't really have a bat. He just, like, held up his arms. And then we'd, like, run away from him.
No, he would pick us up.
Okay, so this game is called Academics. On a beautiful summer morning, I would wake you guys up and say, come and do your academics. And you sit at a table, and I would give you brain benders and have you read and answer questions. And then we'd go do something fun, and I'd have you write about it. Then I'd edit it.
This is another song.
It's by All Star Weekend. It's called Hey Princess. I think it's how I found them.
One last song.
Okay.
It has 2.1 billion views with 11 million likes and 10 million dislikes.
Like, why did you not like it? I kind of like it.
It used to have more dislikes than likes. If someone knows why it's so disliked, comment down below, because I've always wondered.
I think it just became a trend. Okay, so that's it for our music selections. You can go check those out. Thank you very much for watching this video. From a cringy person to you, thanks. Right now I'm the physical embodiment of cringe, so I'm gonna probably change. If you want to like for my torture, because my legs are extremely hot and it's like 90 degrees outside and we went out there.
Yeah, and my glasses that I wore for like 1 minute, I can still feel them on my face because they're so much heavier than my glasses now.
Hold on.
Bye, that's it.
Here's Julie's zoology that she doesn't want me to show. Ooh, that looks sick. Okay, go.
Oh no! Oh no! Let me do some more stuff.
Yes, queen!
Second, third.
Why are you clicking on your face?
Why are you clicking on your face?
Because I'm self-centered.
Oh, okay, do the outro.
Thanks.